You know that the Zen 2 is getting released now and getting new performance upgrades, beating its rivalry to its grave. But we tend to forget the original Goliath from AMD, the Athlon series, and within this, we are going to see the processor that started this, the Athlon Classic. The Athlon had a 64 KB L1 cache and 512 KB L2 cache. It supported MMX and 3D now and ran anywhere around 500 to 700 MHz for the K7 and 550 to 1000 MHz for the K75. The original Athlon, also known as the Athlon Classic, was released on June 23rd of 1999. It belonged to the 7th generation of AMD's processor and used a new architecture that increased IPC or instruction per clock considerably and allowed AMD to push the clock rates up to 1 GHz. Previously, AMD's floating point performance lagged way behind its Intel counterpart. However, with the Athlon, the processor was equipped with a triple issue out of order floating point unit that surpassed Intel's competing processor. Athlon was compatible with the new DDR RAM, which featured greater bandwidth and performance compared to traditional SDRAM. All of this meant Athlon was 10% faster than the Pentium 3 at the same clock speed for applications and even faster at 20% for gaming workload. But the Athlon wasn't all sunshine and ponies. It too had several problems. The Athlon Classic had an cartridge-based design, meaning the CPU was packaged as a rectangular cartridge that needs to be inserted vertically, just like a RAM module. AMD used separate RAM chips soldered onto the same package as the CPU for L2 cache. This enabled AMD to install larger amount of L2 cache, but the cache ran at lower clock speeds. This helped cutting the cost of the processor, as a similar amount of on-die L2 cache would cost exponentially more than this. However, the RAM modules were incapable of keeping up with the processor's clock speed as they were farther away from a supposedly on-die L2 cache that was just above the CPU. There were many revisions for this design, however it was clear on later designs of the processor that this way of caching is incapable of matching with the processor. The processor were also multiply locked, meaning they cannot be overclocked. This was the first time AMD had done this, as resellers are just changing their clock speeds of older Athlon and selling it at a price premium. These processors were not stable and crashed frequently, and AMD was getting its reputation damaged. Hence, to protect its reputation, the company made the processor multiplayer locked. Commercially, the Athlon Classic was an enormous success. One reason being that Intel suffered from a series of major production and design along with quality control issues at the time. This made the market wide and free for AMD to take over. The AMD Athlon Thunderbird was AMD's response to the lackluster L2 cache performance, which was hampering CPU performance. The Athlon Classic was later succeeded by Athlon Thunderbirds and K8 processors. These processors had the L2 cache integrated directly onto the CPU die. Though the L2 cache size was cut in half, it ran at the same speed as the CPU, drastically improving performance. Other than the on-die L2 cache, the Thunderbird and subsequent models had gradual performance boost over time. Hey, so if you've been liking this video, don't forget to subscribe. No pressure or anything, just commenting.